Welcome to part 5 of Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. You are going to learn how to write and publish a blog post on Blogger website, with few tips to index blog posts on Blogger. You may skip to each timestamp if you know how to set up these things already. Since this is a full steps-by-steps tutorial series, I will show you how to set up a simple Blogger site and get Google AdSense approval. Let's dive in right now. Back to where I stopped in part 4 of BAT, click the posts on Blogger sidebar. As I have mentioned earlier in a previous video, posts is the place where you create, edit, and manage all your blog posts. Click plus new post on upper left side to create and write a blog post. This is where you can type the content, put the title for your post at here. You can use these tools to improve your content structure, and this part is used to change the setting of this content post. Just like my important pages, I have over a dozen pieces of content that was written a few months ago. I will tell you how to write good content, but you may look at how I write content for a blog post first. Personally, I like to finish the settings of a blog post first before typing any content, but actually you are free to change the settings anytime, or even before you publish the post. You can click the permalink to fill in the link for your post. If you choose automatic permalink, Blogger will use the words in the title to make up a link for you automatically. For example, let's say I type top 10 movies about the galaxy, then Blogger's automatic permalink will remove the from title and form a link with top 10 movies about galaxy under the permalink section. Besides, there is also a limit on this automatic link. If your post has a long title, then Blogger might take a maximum of 7 or 8 words to form an automatic link. Normally, I wouldn't use automatic permalink for my Blogger posts, because it is hard to organize, and the length of the link is not under my control. So you can follow what I have done here to arrange the link in a neat format. After I decide the format of the link, I proceed to write the title of this post. It's the first post to introduce the SEO exam P, and there are 6 posts I'm going to write for this topic. This is why I write SEO exam P, and adding a number of 1 to 6 as the blog post link for each part of this exam P content. By arranging the link in such a format, I can remove any SOA or exam P blog post by simply clicking the new request button here and selecting remove all URLs with this prefix. By the way, you don't have to write SOA exam content, as what I have shown in this video to get Google AdSense approval. Instead, you can write anything you like, just make sure your content is original, unique, and informative. Moreover, you should avoid writing some content that I have marked as low-value content in this YouTube tutorial video, or else you are not going to get any Google AdSense approval. Click the link on your left upper side to see which types of content is a low-value content from Google AdSense perspective. Back to the blog post edit page, I fill in SOA and exam P as the main labels in my first blog post, try to add 1 to 3 labels, and don't use over 5 to 7 labels for a single content post. The search description at here is where you can do some search engine optimization. You can do SEO on the Blogger post by summarizing what your post is about with less than 150 characters. Just mention the keywords in your content, and make sure the sentence looks okay inside the description box. Under the Published On section, you can either automatically publish your posts after you click the paper plane icon inside the orange box, or set a date and time to publish your content. Select any date you want to publish your blog post using the calendar at the bottom, and choose the time by clicking here. So now I have done the setting of this post, let's move on to write the content. In order to receive Google AdSense approval, make sure most of your posts, maybe above 80% to 90%, are long textual content, which means there should be at least 800 words per post to make your content look long enough to be a high-quality content. You can also use the trick I'm using now to measure whether your post is long enough or not. Make sure there are no original size images inside the blog post, and you can press the page up button and calculate how many times you can press the page up button. To be a long textual content, the number of page up you can press should be more than 10 times. For this blog post about SOA exam P, I can press the page up button 13 times. If the number of page up or page down buttons you can press is less than 10 times, then you should add more words and other additional information inside your content to make your blog post long enough from Google AdSense perspective. So now I have done editing my first posts, let's keep it as a draft before I show you the way to publish Blogger posts that are likely to be indexed by Google Search Console in order to prevent the appearance of discovered currently not indexed issue on Search Console. The second post I write here is also related to SOA exam P, but this blog post is having a short textual content this time. You can see the number of page up or page down buttons I can press is less than 4 times, which is far below from what I have told you just now. But actually it is okay to publish short textual form content with the number of words per post between 250 words to 500 words, as long as you can publish at least 80% of long textual form content on your website. Now I will speed up what I have done, and let me explain some myths about Blogger posts and Google AdSense approval. I remember there was someone who told me you have to use your own images to create content, you can't use images from Google, or else you can't get Google AdSense approval. The answer for this question is a no. You may use online images as long as it is allowed. There are many websites that provide free stock images or stock videos for you to download, such as Pixabay, Pexels, Unsplash, etc. Remember to add attribution or give credit if you are required to do so. You may also create your own image using Canva, Photoshop, PowerPoint, or even using Microsoft Paint, but Google AdSense doesn't really care about your images unless you publish some images that violate AdSense program policies, such as something related to 18+, weapons or drugs. Even though images are not really essential in getting Google AdSense approval, you should add a few images inside each content post to improve its readability and make your blog or website more memorable. I even heard someone say you have to publish your content daily or regularly to get Google AdSense approval on website and Blogger. The answer is still no. Google AdSense is always looking for websites that have been provided with a bunch of high-quality content, so how you publish your content and blog posts is not a factor in getting Google AdSense approval on any websites, including Blogger site. It is okay not to publish blog posts regularly. You will see all the blog posts on my Blogger site showing in this video were published within 2 days, but they still can get Google AdSense approval. Another small issue I heard recently was about whether bilingual websites can get Google AdSense approval or not. I can't give you an accurate answer here. But I got few English posts on my first blog, written in Chinese, when Google AdSense approved my Blogger website. However, there were 4 English posts only compared to 38 Chinese posts in that blog, so I think a bilingual Blogger site is somehow okay to get Google AdSense approval. But the best practice for your Blogger site is to publish content using a single language. Now let's move back to the footage. I have created all my content here after a few rounds of copy and paste the HTML codes. I will show you the way I publish my posts through scheduling. I click the earliest post and set a specific date and time under Blogger settings. So I plan to publish my first post at 5 p.m. Click the paper plane icon inside the orange box and press confirm to publish the post. Then I schedule to publish these posts with an interval of 1 hour until all posts are published on my Blogger site. The last post is scheduled to publish at 9 a.m. tomorrow. I will continue my explanation after a few posts are published. From my perspective, don't publish your posts immediately after you have done all the checking. Schedule to publish your posts is a much better option, because it might increase the chance Google crawl and index all your posts and pages on Blogger site. Few months ago, I found out that this method can totally fix the discovered currently not indexed problem shown on Google Search Console for my Blogger websites, and none of my posts have dealt with the discovered currently not indexed issue since then, especially on my finance blogging site. You may visit the link I added in the description box if you want to learn more about a few ways to fix discovered currently not indexed issues on Google Search Console. Before the end of this video, I strongly recommend you to also watch this low-value content video on my YouTube channel to learn the format of high-quality content for getting Google AdSense approval. That's all for part 5 of Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. Feel free to ask me something in the comment section if you still have any doubts about Blogger creation and setup. You are going to learn how to index Blogger posts and update sitemap in Google Search Console in order to get Google AdSense approval in part 6 of the BAT series. By the way, once my YouTube channel has 1,000 subscribers and reaches 4,000 hours of watch time, I will pick one subscriber of this YouTube channel and award you something. If you are the lucky one, I will help you to get Google AdSense approval free. Just make sure you click the subscribe button, leave a like and comment in any Google AdSense related video to be eligible for this lucky draw. Before we move on to the next YouTube tutorial video, tell me which factors you think are the most important factor to get Google AdSense approval on a website. A. Daily traffic. B. Number of posts. C. Website theme. Or D. Content quality. Leave your choice in the comment section, and I will create a video to specifically talk about the most popular option after the end of this Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. You are the one to decide which content you want to see, so choose it wisely. Click the watch list on your left to watch the next part of BAT series, or click the watch list on your right to learn more about Google AdSense and the ways to fix policy violations on Google AdSense. Goodbye and have a nice day.